From the foothills of the Rocky Mountains, it's E-Town with this week's guest from Ireland, Columbia recording artist Eleanor McAvoy, biologist Carol Beidelman, and special guest, Capitol recording artist Richard Thompson. Right now, here's your host, Nick Forster.
Thank you, Ellen. Thanks, everybody. Welcome to E-Town, where we get together every week to listen to some great live music, to talk a little bit about the world around us. The world of music and ideas is what we're about, what draws us together every week. And I think what we're really after around here is something kind of unprocessed, unfiltered, a little true feeling, a glimpse of love, a chance to be understood or a chance to be heard, make a difference. That's what we're up to around here. That's the real stuff. And that's really where our first guest lives. That's where he hangs out, in that spot. So would you please welcome back to E-Town once again, Mr. Richard Thompson.
Thank you. Thank you. Thanks. Nice to be back here in elusive and hard to find on the map, E-Town. If you don't want me, I'll dry my tears and move on. If you don't want me, I'll dry my tears and move on. You treated me just good enough until now. But if you're tired of me, I'll get over you somehow. Oh, if you don't want me, dry my tears and move on. You don't need me, there's someone else who needs me up there. Try to hide your shame, dear, from my eyes. In your hand. You don't want me, I'll dry my tears and move on.
So are you still as just the hardest working man in show business, out there working all the time?
That's what they say. Where's my cloak?
Your handler. No, I continue to be not only impressed by the fact that you're working all the time and making new records and traveling and touring and playing still, but it seems from my perspective that it kind of gets better, you know?
Well, I'm a very late developer.
Yeah, well, that's a good thing.
The teachers told me at school, you know, that it would all turn out badly if I didn't stop looking out the window. It's just taken me, you know, metaphorically, I've been looking out the window for a very long time, and I'm just about catching up now.
It's a unique perspective.
I'm going to try and peak at about 78 years old.
Yeah.
That's also when I'm going to start smoking, drinking, and taking heroin in a big way. Because I figure I won't die of it. So I'm saving all the drugs for later. It's going to be great.
It's the only honorable death for somebody in your business. I was thinking about that only because I think it was about 30 years ago you were at an opening act for Crosby, Stills, Nash & Young. We're still touring, but may have peaked.
Wow.
That must have been an interesting time 30 years ago to be out there opening for those guys. Do you remember?
It was. Yeah.
You were still saving all the drugs for later, I thought.
Yeah, it was good. I suppose in contrast to, you know, the 90s, which seems, you know, in terms of popular music, seems slightly barren, every band sounded different. It's because people had lousy guitars and amps and equipment, for one thing, so everything sounded sort of crappy in a different way. Instead of really nice in the same way, you know. And that was good. Yeah, but bands seem to have more original style. You know, you could tell, you know, the Kinks from the Yardbirds and the, you know, Hap Shash and the Coloured Coat from... The Strawberry Alarm Clock. And the other great thing about sort of 1968 was that everybody had a record contract, which just doesn't happen anymore.
Do you still, with your day offs, do you still get outside and do a, you know, look for the occasional bird or spend some time in your garden? I mean, do you spend some time outdoors when you can?
Oh, I do, yeah. Where I live, there's a mountain at the top of the road and there's an ocean at the bottom. So there's always opportunities, you know, to go biking or... hiking up in the hills, and it's Santa Monica National Park is an extraordinarily rich, diverse area of wildlife.
Well, I was always puzzled. In fact, I was puzzled by your interest in and fascination with birds, and to sort of help me understand it better, we actually brought somebody in today who's a real pro and going to help us all sort of get the hang of it. So you never know.
Fantastic.
Yeah, we'll find out more as the show goes on.
Good stuff.
So that's good. And meanwhile. You got a new record out. We didn't even talk about that, which is just shows you how our priorities are appropriately misplaced.
Oh, that's okay.
Well, Mock Tutor and good record.
Oh. Yeah.
Anyway, I like the way you organize your songs in one way or another. This seems to be largely about your old neighborhood in London, right?
Yeah, I sort of like suburbs in a really bleak way. And of course, in Britain, you know, but growing up in the 50s in Britain, it was all like that, those black and white Ealing comedies, you know, everything was in black and white, and so it was bleak and grey and depressing, but I like that. That's good.
Yeah. Anyway, glad you're here. It's nice to have you back. It's kind
Thank
of like
you. Thanks
it's
for having me.
Kind of like a regular thing. I like this. Anyway, welcome back, if you would, Richard Thompson.
Tired of working every day. Now the weekend's come, gonna throw my troubles away. If you got the cat bell, mister, you're too alright. I want to see the bright lights tonight. Meet me at the station, don't be late. I need to spend some money. Just won't wait. Take me to the dance and hold me tight. I want to see the bright lights tonight. There's crazy people running all over town. There's a silver band just a marching up and down. And the white boys are all spoiling. I want to see the bright lights tonight. Meet me at the station, don't be late. I need to spend some money and it just won't wait. Take me to the dance and hold me tight. I want to see the bright lights tonight. Take me to the dance and
Richard Thompson, latest CD out on Capitol Records is called Mock Tutor in Los Angeles, California. Richard's going to be back a little later on in the show for some more music.
Your visit to E-Town is made possible in part by Celestial Seasonings, helping you nurture your good health and good nature with a full line of teas and natural and organic products. Celestial Seasonings, it's what you do for you. On the web at celestialseasonings.com. By Invesco. You should know what Invesco knows. On the web at Invesco.com. And also, Cascadian Farm, makers of a full line of certified organic foods, including frozen entrees and meals like spinach lasagna. Cascadian Farm, better food for a better world. You're listening to E-Town.
You're listening to E-Town on Classical 88.5 WYSU-FM Youngstown, 90.1 in Ashtabula, and 97.5 in New Wilmington.
I'm Nick Forster. You're listening to E-Town. Richard Thompson's going to be back a little later on the show. And coming up, we're going to talk with wildlife biologist Carol Beidelman and a great singer from Ireland, Eleanor McAvoy, is here too. First, I want to tell you about our next guest. Eleanor McAvoy was a bit of a child prodigy growing up in Ireland, taking up piano at the age of 4, violin at 6, and eventually playing with the Junior Irish Youth Orchestra and the National Symphony Orchestra of Ireland. But her real passion, it turns out, has long been her own songs and a career in popular music. In 1992, her contribution to the anthology A Woman's Heart, which became the best-selling album in Irish chart history, made her a big dang star, helped her get started on her own career. Her latest record is called Snapshots. It's out on Columbia Records. She's here with her friend Liam Bradley on percussion. Would you please welcome to E-Town for her first visit, Eleanor McAvoy.
Thank you. Is his hair still as long? Are his eyes still as blue? Can his face still conceal every clue to his mood? Does his brow still display every beat of his heart? Did he ask after me? Did you send my regards? And did you tell him that I've died in every way that matters? And did you tell him how I cry with every I'd tell him myself, but I don't have the nerve, and I know to my shame this is all I deserve, but I hope for my sake you were not indiscreet. If he asked how I was, hope you light through your teeth. Oh, did you tell him that I've died in every way that matters? And did you tell him how I cry with every day that passes? That I am raw and bruised and torn, that I can't function anymore. Well, did you tell him that? And if he didn't want to know, oh, my friends, don't tell me that. Did you never speak my name? Did he never even ask? Or did you tell him that I've died in every way that matters? And did you tell him how I cry with every day that passes? That I am raw and bruised and torn, that I can't function anymore. Well, did you tell him that?
Thank you.
Every now and then, if somebody's been unfaithful, we've a tendency to say, certainly where I come from, it's not what you did, it's the fact that you lied. Now, of course, it's not the fact that the person has lied, is it? The song's called Sleepless.
Thank you.
betrayed. And I'm not above singing stories of love. But God, how my stories have changed. It's not what you did. Kept me sleepless.
You must have been a very focused and self-disciplined young person to have been such an accomplished classical musician.
You must be joking.
No, I'm just a dad, and I'm trying to think about imagining my kids doing that, practicing hours and hours all the time. What, you never practiced? It just came to you.
If my violin teacher, who's dead now, God bless her, but if she'd heard you say that, she's probably laughing somewhere up there. I never did any work.
Well, it must have worked out. Must have been a clash of two worlds. There you are playing in this big symphony orchestra, and then meanwhile you're sort of wanting to go out and put on your leather jacket and get wild.
There used to be a little bit of that, yeah. You'd be sitting down kind of playing your Mozart, and the gig would be coming to an end, and I'd be thinking, oh, I'm playing in this little rock club now later on, and you'd be, you know, spiking up your hair after taking the long dress off and putting something else on.
And what did your fellow classical musicians think about this? They said, oh, there she goes.
They didn't actually know for a long time because... and then, funny, when they started realizing that I sang and wrote songs, they used to come along to the gigs sometimes. And it was great. It was lovely.
And where did you meet Liam? Liam's doing a great job in percussion over there.
Well, Liam has played with everybody in Ireland who... Everybody, Maura O'Connell, Dolores Keane, Van Morrison, everybody in Ireland. Basically, you'll see him at the back of albums. You turn over your Irish album, there he is, Liam Bradley at the back. And luckily, he's with me on this trip, so
yeah.
Particularly nice.
Let me also ask you, I know I read somewhere that you're one of the places you like to visit on the web is a site that has to do with the sort of violence in East Timor or something like that. Is that a concern of yours?
It is. I mean, I'm a bit wary of songwriters that get up on podiums and start speaking about things, because I always feel that our area of expertise is harmonies and grooves and rhythms and chords, not really political issues.
Right.
But East Timor, what was happening there was so horrific, it was very difficult not to get involved. Thankfully, they've come a long way towards resolving it. I know they've a bit further to go, but at least they have their independence.
And yeah. And the conflicts at home, how do you feel about all that?
Oh, Lord. Well, the peace process is still going on, and let's just keep our fingers crossed that some good is going to come of it.
Yeah. We're meanwhile glad you made the trip over here, and good to sort of get to meet you and hear you. This is new for us. So.
Well, I tell you, usually they said that there's a house band, and I went, oh no, not a house band. Can you imagine my surprise when I turned up and I met these guys? You know, it was ooh.
Thank you. Thank you. Shall we? You want to do another?
Yeah, I'd love to.
Yeah. Welcome back, Eleanor McAvoy.
And I'm joined, of course, with Nick Helen and the E-Town Band on this song. I know that you're all very socially aware here in E-Town. I'm going to get serious for 1 minute and just tell you about an Irish woman that was shot dead in her car. A woman called Veronica Guerin. She was a journalist and she was shot dead by the criminals in Ireland. And the week after her death, I think everybody in Ireland was very put out, very upset, very depressed by this. And I wrote this song. It's called Easy to Lose Hope. Hometown's dear to me, it's always in my sight. My city's shadows walk around in broad daylight. They leave and shoot a woman down for what she writes. So now you pay for civil liberty with life. So hard it's easy to lose hope for everyone. So bad it's easier to never take it on. And we can't lose hope, and we cannot hide away. We can overcome, but we must be strong, and we must not be afraid. The search for peace within. You must not ever stop the search for peace within. 'Cause if you find it, there's no better prize to win. With all the ugly. you. Liam Bradley on percussion and backing vocals. The E-Town Band. Nick, Helen, thank you.
Eleanor McAvoy from Ireland. Her latest record out on Columbia is called Snapshots.
Were there any bird calls that you recognized in that?
Nope.
The birds of the Smoky Mountains were not your forte.
Not my area.
Do you do any bird calls? Do you?
Grief, no. No.
I can actually do. I can do one. Let's see if you can guess which one this is. This will be easy.
It's the white pelican. Yeah, question the white pelican.
I see. We're in the company of the true expert. With that in mind, we better get right to music. Welcome back, Richard Thompson.
Thank you. Promises she twists the knife again. I suck my memory, I close my eyes, and then she takes another bite. She twists the knife again. Never leaves me. My dignity makes a dunce of me and makes company. Oh, bygone and be a bygone. She throws a spanner in, she puts the screws on. In the middle of a head, she twists the knife again. Get up with mine, she twists the knife again. When I think I'm off the hook, she gets me. She twists the knife again. She twists the knife again now. Richard Thompson, Los Angeles, California, by way of London. His latest CD out on Capitol is called Mock Tutor.
Richard Thompson. We're going to do one more song right now, get everybody out here. I want to thank everyone for being part of the show. This is a challenge every time we have a show to sort of figure out what is it that we're going to be able to find that we can do together. And Richard was immediately drawn to doing an Irish tune. I want to thank everybody for being part of the show this week. Of course, from L.A., Richard Thompson, our interview guest, Carol Beidelman, helping us understand the world of birds. Our award winner, also from out in Los Angeles, Tony Rhymes, working with the homeless vets in L.A. I want to also want to thank Eleanor McAvoy, did a great job. Liam on percussion. I want to thank the E-Tones, Helen Forrester. I'm Nick Forrester. Hope you can be with us next week right here in E-Town.
For the summertime has come out, and the leaves are sweetly blooming, and the wild mountain time comes among the blooming heather. When God lets me go, and we're all going together to put wild mountain time all around.
E-Town is produced and edited by Nick and Helen Forrester with help from Ron Bostwick, Denise Roshani, and Donna Giardina. Our program was recorded live this week at the Boulder Theater. Thanks to the E-Tones, Nick Forrester on guitar and mandolin, Chris Engelman on bass, Christian Teal on drums, Ron Jolly on keyboards, and joining them this week, Rob Rebholz on horns. To know more about this week's award winner, Tony Rynas, or to comment about E-Town, contact us on the net, info@etown.org, our website, www.etown.org, or write us at Box 954, Boulder, Colorado, 80306. The national distribution of E-Town is made possible by the support of E-Town's family of sponsors, this station, and listeners like you. This is a production of the E-Town Radio Network.
This is Classical 88.5 WYSU-FM Youngstown, 90.1 in Ashtabula, and 97.5 in New Wilmington, celebrating 30 years of fine arts radio. Support for WYSU is provided by Time Warner Cable, featuring Roadrunner High Speed Online, a way to reach the internet that doesn't tie up the phone line. For information, www.neo.rr.com. Thank you.
south of Rocky Mountains, it's E-Town with this week's guest from Hawaii, dancing cat recording artist Led Kapana, author and naturalist Rick Bass, and from Woodstock, New York, rounder recording artist Jules Shear. Right now, here's your host, Nick Forster.
Thank you, Ellen. Thanks, everybody. Welcome to E-Town. Get together every week to listen to some live music, talk a little bit about the world around us. We've got three guests this week who live thousands of miles away from each other, although they all live in America. They express themselves in different mediums, different styles, but they have some things in common. They all pay attention to their surroundings, their emotional connection to a place or a sound or a melody or a scent or whatever it is that inspires them, and then they've all found ways to express that inspiration. And there are tons of us who don't take the time to connect, to notice where we are, and even more who haven't found a way to share that stuff. But these guys are remarkable men, I think. Led Kapana from Hawaii, Rick Bass from Montana, and our first guest, please welcome him back from Woodstock, New York, a great songwriter, Mr. Jules Shear.
Thank you. Thank you. Pleasure to be here. I have his new album out. The album's called Allow Me. Usually, when I put out a new album, it's usually the songs that I wrote just before I made that album. And if a song doesn't make it on that album, it usually just doesn't get recorded. But on this new album, there is one song that I wrote 10 years ago. I was living in New York City. I just moved back up to Woodstock, New York, where I live now. And a friend of mine called me and said he was a record producer. He had produced some of my songs on various people's albums, and he said, you know, we're going to sign the band, and I thought it might be cool if you would go up there and write some songs with them, because you're going to be living in Woodstock, and Robbie Robertson isn't in the band anymore, and he wrote 90% of their songs. And when I was a kid, I used to like watch the turntable go around staring at band albums, and I was just like, you know, it just sent me into a heavenly feeling hearing these guys. I didn't know where it came from. I didn't know what they were, but I loved it. And I was pretty intimidated, and I went up to this place where they were rehearsing. I was told to go to this barn in Woodstock, and I drove up there. I sat in front of the place for like 15 minutes, and I tried to get up my courage, and I finally got up in the nerve and knocked on the door, and nobody answered. And I heard there was noise going on in there, but nobody was answering, and so I knocked as hard as I could, and the door opened, and standing in front of me was Rick Danko from the band. Now, I knew there were some new guys in the band because all the original members weren't there, and I had hoped that maybe one of the new guys would answer the door, but it was Rick Danko standing there in front of me. I said, Rick, my name's Jules Shear. And he said, who? And that made me feel really good. I got to tell you. And I said, my name's Jules Shear, and your producer, Rick, sent me up here to write songs with you. He said, to write songs? Well, come on in then. And then he was really friendly. And then I went in, and we wrote a bunch of songs over the course of a couple weeks there. We wrote a bunch of songs, and it was an amazing experience for me to be around these guys. But there was one guy who was playing piano. Richard Manuel was the original piano player in the band. There was another guy playing piano, and I asked around to find out who he was, and his name was Stan Celeste. And Stan kept saying, I got this song, I'm writing it for Richard Manuel, and I'd really like you to finish it. And I just thought, I'll get to it, really, because we'd started a whole bunch of songs, and with the band, you start a lot of things don't get finished, and I really wanted to get these songs finished. So I was trying to get them done, and he kept saying, I got this little piece of something, will you listen to it? And finally, he played it for me, and I just thought it was beautiful, and I said, yes, I'll work on that song. And he was calling it Too Soon Gone. And I said, yeah, I'll work on that. But I didn't. And a couple weeks later, Stan himself died of a heart attack in that barn. And it then fell to me to complete Stan's song as a tribute to him and to Richard Manuel. And the band did record this on their first album after Robbie left the band, an album called Jericho. And then I ended up singing, unfortunately, at Rick's memorial service a few months ago. I really don't want to be singing this at too many memorial services in the future. But I don't want to sing it tonight for anybody who has lost someone in an untimely fashion.
Mm-hmm.
Last night, constellations watched me walk at 12:30. Some people you don't see the whole picture at once. Like you're filling the gaps and the stars all by yourself. Who has time in this world to worry? Drives you crazy and makes you mad. Then you make the mistake just a little too late. You're missing something now you never knew you had. So how do I answer these blues you say I got? Too soon gone, too soon gone. Time makes me pay for these memories I bought. And you're too soon gone, you're too soon gone. No one lives forever. But you're too soon gone. You're too soon gone. Well, pretty soon now, all this ice will melt. The buds will get ready to break. With every leaf that grows, language that it knows says the winter will return here. These trees are gonna shade. So how do I answer these blues you say I got? Too soon gone, too soon gone. Time slips me forward, but this memory is caught. And you're too soon gone, you're too soon gone. You're too soon gone, too soon
good one. We had the pleasure of having Rick Danko on E-Town a couple of times not that long ago.
Yeah, it was one of the last shows he did, wasn't it, E-Town show?
Such a wild bass player that made it sound, I mean, no one could even figure out what he was playing, but it sounded great.
It was like he wasn't like a musician, he was just like music, you know? Yeah. It was just like, he was just music, you know? He just had it like dripping off of him, and I just like spent time just like, you know, running around with a bucket trying to get some of it, you know.
It's pretty amazing. Now, you mentioned earlier that this record is not like your other records, in that it's just a pile of songs that are the most recent batch, and you either record them or you don't. Is this one a pile that means something different? Is it a collection?
Well, no, it's more just a reflection of like what's been happening in my life, I guess, you know. So every album is sort of like that, and it's kind of cool because I can go back over albums that I've done, like, I don't know how many I've done with bands and by myself, maybe 14 or 15. And when I hear them, you know, I just know right what was happening right then. Mm-hmm. Too Soon Gone was just a song that, like, I started playing live, and then, you know, people were really responding to it and wanting to own a recording of it mm-hmm. by me. So I just thought I would do it.
You know, Jules, I'm distracted by your shirt. I can't help it.
This is radio. Get over it.
I know. I got to get over it. Or maybe I should share it. I'll just have to describe it to our listeners. It's black on black, which is, of course, an interesting color scheme. It's got the beautiful sequins. It's got the flowers. It's happening. I think it's distracting, but it looks good.
When I was a kid, there used to be this catalog that came in the mail, and it was called the Alleganza catalog, and I loved this catalog dearly. I could never afford anything in it, but it was all clothes like you didn't see in Pittsburgh, and it was like 60s soul guy clothes, you know? Yeah. And like, so I would get that catalog, and I would just like look through and go, oh my God, look at that. Oh God. And like, it wouldn't matter if I could have bought them. I couldn't have worn them anywhere in Pittsburgh, you know? But I just craved, I loved it, you know? And so when I saw the shirt, it just took me back.
Right,
you know?
There. Alleganza, yeah.
Alleganza.
I can see the shoes that you don't have but are probably looking for right now. No, anyway, I mentioned before, it's a brave thing to do what you do, to write songs that are tied to your world and share them, let them see what happens. And you've been a guy who's not only shared them with an audience, but you've shared them with a lot of other artists. A bunch of people recorded your songs. You know, everybody knows, people like Cyndi Lauper, Art Garfunkel, Olivia Newton-John, The Bangles, Amy Mann. I mean, there's a few, but lots of people record your songs.
It happens from time to time.
Do you like some of their versions?
I do. It's always like an honor when somebody records one of your songs, and you have to remember, even if you don't really care for that version as much as you care for your own, that the honor is good to bear in mind, that like, this is an honor. This is like, you know, so you should just like, you know, get over whatever weird feelings you have.
Is there an example of a song where you really had to sort of hang on to that feeling of honor, that sense of honor?
Do you think I would tell you that? No, never.
Okay, right. No one would ever record another one of your tunes again.
Yeah, that's
probably.
Right. Yeah. The Wrath.
Right.
There are people who believe that that's like the sign of a great song, that it can be done a whole bunch of different ways. I don't know if that's true or not, actually.
Well, I also think it's true that at least a fairly high percentage of your songs were on the pretty dark side of things.
Actually,
although this new record is not. This new record is different.
Yeah. Sad jewels, happy jewels. It's like, just because, you know, people have been giving me grief about this album a little bit, just because it's like...
Because it's too happy.
Because, like, especially the last album, which was really downbeat, and this one's kind of upbeat, but I can't help it. I feel this way, you know?
Hey, I'm all for it, man. Feeling good is fun. Yeah. Feeling good is fun. Well, listen, we're going to get back to some more music. Welcome back, if you would, from Woodstock, New York, Mr. Jules Shear.
You got a natural elegance around you, with a little Bleecker Street thrown in. You say, oh my baby, don't you think maybe it's a waste of time you're thinking about sin? And isn't that exactly like you, girl, to always choose the middle one? You say, oh my baby, don't you think maybe the world sure weighs a ton? Oh, this encouragement is killing me. It's so comfortable right here on your floor. I don't want to know what it is. How'd you get it? Where'd you get it? You just tell me, do I get more?
Oh. all bow down before the guitar god. That was a joke.
It's a very pretty little soap bubble, but memories are made of this. You say, oh my baby, don't you think maybe you ought to just see it as it is? It's a very pretty little soap bubble, it'd be so easy to bust. Oh my baby, what a perfect way we found to go from dust to dust. All this encouragement is killing me. What are you looking at me like that for? I don't wanna know what it is. How'd you get it? Where'd you get it? You just tell me, do I get more? Well, you just tell me, do I get more now? You just tell me, do I get more? I don't wanna know what it is. How'd you get it? Where'd you get it? You just tell me, do I get more? Well, tell me now, do I get more? Tell me now, do I get more? Tell me now, do I get more? You just tell me, do I get more?
Jill Shear from Woodstock, New York. Latest CD is called Allow Me out on Roundy Records. Jill's is going to be back a little later on in the show.
I just want to tell you about our next guest, Led Ka'apana. He grew up on the Big Island of Hawaii in a family that not only loved traditional Hawaiian music, but played it and sang all the time, aunts and uncles, cousins, parents, brothers and sisters. But he emerged as one of the favorite sons of Hawaiian music and the tradition of the slackee. It's a beautiful sound. It's full of the images of the Hawaiian landscape. Please welcome to E-Town, Led Ka'apana.
Aloha. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much. I recorded that song on an album. It's a love song that was composed by one of our auntie from Honolulu. The next song I'd like to do is one of the songs that was composed by my dad. And it's on my new CD called Black Sand. That is the title track. Thank you.
Led Apana. So tell me what this house that you grew up in was like when you were a kid.
There was no electricity. We brought up the old style and, you know, we learned how to live off the land, and the ocean was like our icebox where we got our fish from and went hunting for food.
Yeah. And so you played a lot of music because there was no TV, no radio, no electricity.
Yeah. That is correct. Yeah. And the way I learned music was I used to watch, you see, every Fridays and Saturdays, my dad, my uncles, and aunties that used to come over the house and used to have big parties, and we were small, and I just used to watch how they used to hold the fingerings on the guitar. Then.
Yeah. Would they last all day, or people hang out all day, play music? All night?
All night. Sometimes you party three nights in a row, you know. The first crew goes on to 12 o'clock, the next crew take over, and we were just, you know, young and learning the music.
They let the kids learn and come in and play music and sing and learn the songs?
We did that when they were, they had 2 minutes to drink already.
Yeah, well.
They fell asleep, so we had a chance to grab the guitar and start. They couldn't hear.
Nothing like a good 3-day party to give you a chance to play a lot. So your new CD is called Black Sand. And I've been to some of those black sand beaches on the Big Island. Mm-hmm. What is that near where you grew up?
Yeah, it was known as the most famous black sand in Kalapana.
Yeah, but there's been some volcanic activity around there also since you grew up, right?
Yep.
Did it change the landscape?
Today it is changed. Yeah, there's nothing there but black sand. There's nothing there but lava. Yeah.
Oh really?
Yeah. All our houses is under the lava, so everything looks different today.
Wow.
Yeah.
I suspect that's true. So just so that people listening to the show can have a sense of this, the kind of music you're playing really came out of the late 19th century, right? The late 1800s. And
yes.
Some of these songs were written around that time, and mm-hmm. somehow the guitar found its way to Hawaii and
to the West Coast, the cowboys.
Yeah. Many of them came to the Big Island, right?
Yes, to upgrade the cattle industry.
The cattle ranch, yeah. And then this wonderful music, this kind of gentle music that's more Hawaiian than anything mm-hmm. else.
The Hawaiians created their own style of playing, but
yeah.
What they did is they retuned the guitars and
open tunings.
Open tunings, yeah.
Are you worried that Hawaiian music is going to continue to evolve with all these other things coming into it, or is it going to stay kind of pure?
I'm the only one, and the rest of the guys at my age is still trying to carry on the traditional Hawaiian music. We don't want to lose that, you know. I try to pass it down to the next generation. To have them continue this music.
Maybe what you need to do is just turn off your electricity and invite your family over for a 3-day party, and then all these kids will learn.
That is correct.
Anyway, I really enjoy your playing, and I'm glad you make it. It's a long trip, but glad you could make it.
Oh, thanks.
Well, thanks, Led. Welcome back, Led Ka'apana from the Big Island in Hawaii.
Thank you. Mahalo. At this time, I would like to have Nick come join me and do it for you. Good old Hawaiian song called Sweet Georgia Brown. Thank you.
Kaapana from the Big Island of Hawaii, playing that classic Hawaiian number, Sweet Georgia Grinder.
You listen to that Let Kaapana at all?
Man, he was killing.
Yeah. You ever been to Hawaii?
No, but that guy, he kills me and then I go to heaven. It's just like too great. It's really...
There are people who feel the same way about you. I'm not sure. Well, listen, we're going to get back to some more music. This next song is from your latest CD. He's going to have Cheryl Winston, Helen Forster, and Rebecca Folsom as backup singers. Anyway, welcome back, if you would, for some more music, Mr. Jules Shear.
Between us two, but let's not count the space in miles or smiles. It's been a nightmare that I've been dragged through. I wanna stare into your eyes a while. I'm in love with you.
Day and night.
I'm in love with you.
Day and night.
You can't stop me now. Don't care what you're gonna do. I'm in love with you. I know you're holding on to something bad. You get a little pleasure with your pain. You've been pushed around this whole hard world, just like what the wind does with the rain. I'm in love with you.
Day and night.
I'm in love with you.
Day and night.
You can't stop me now. Don't care what you're gonna do. I'm in love with you. Tracks. I feel the power of the train and the speed. But don't worry, I ain't leaving too fast. That train ain't never gonna stop for me. I'm in love with you.
Day and night.
I'm in love with you.
Day and night.
You can't stop me now. Don't care what you're gonna do. I'm in love with you. I'm in love with you.
Day and night.
I'm in love with you.
Day and night.
I'm in love with you.
Day and night.
You can't stop me now. Don't care what you're gonna do. I'm in love with you.
That's Jules Shear. Latest CD called Allow Me, Around the Records. Cheryl Winston, Rebecca Folsom, and Helen Forster singing harmony on there. We're going to do one more song. We're actually going to get Led Kaapana out here and play a song that's going to be kind of international in a scope that even none of us had anticipated. We knew it was going to be cross-cultural, but we got it even more than we thought. I want to thank everybody for being part of the show this week. Again, Jules Shear did a great job in coming out from Woodstock, New York, sharing some songs from his new CD. I want to thank our award winner from up in Oregon. Her name is Ani Kameinui. And that camp that she's doing for inner city kids sounded really amazing. Naturalist and author Rick Bass, thanks for stopping by. Also dancing cat recording artist Mr. Led Kaapana. Did a beautiful job. Of course, the E-Tones and Helen Forster. You've had fun. Thanks for staying with us. I'm Nick Forster. Hope you can be with us
next week, right here in E-Town.
Blue Spanish eyes, teardrops are falling from your Spanish eyes. Please, please don't cry. This is just adios and not goodbye. Soon I'll return, bringing you all the love your heart can hold. Please say, see, say you in your Spanish eyes, wait for me.
E-Town is produced and edited by Nick and Helen Forrester with help from Donna Giardina, Jim Colombo, and Gretchen Kirchhoff. Our program was recorded live this week at the Boulder Theater. Thanks to the E-Tones, Nick Forrester on guitar, Christian Teal on drums, Chris Engelman on bass, and Dan Geisler sitting in for Ron Jolly on keyboards. To know more about this week's guests or to comment about E-Town, contact us on the net, info@etown.org, our website, www.org, or write us at Box 954, Boulder, Colorado, 80306. National distribution of E-Town is made possible by the support of E-Town's family of sponsors, this station, and listeners like you.
Bringing you all the love your heart can hold. Please say, see, say you and your Spanish eyes will wait. Until my eyes begin to bleed.
colors up above. Rolling through the raining hail, looking for the sunny side of
Contrast, Charlie Patton from 1929, Down the Dirt Road Blues, and Bob Dylan from 1997, Dirt Road Blues. On your Music of the People program, Folk Festival, it's blues, blacks and whites, males and females. We'll continue after a pause for station identification. Fine Arts Radio in northeastern Ohio and western Pennsylvania. This is Classical 88.5, WYSU-FM in Youngstown, 90.1 in Ashtabula, and 97.5 in New Wilmington. Here's two female blues singers, Lucille Bogan from 1929 with Tampa Red on guitar and Pothound Blues. And then we'll have an import, Joanne Kelly from Great Britain with Pig Meat Blues.
You must bring me a job, a money from anywhere. You must bring in the street, just anywhere. You come home every day looking for your stew and beans. You come home every day looking for your stew and beans. And you have got no any pothound I've ever seen. Now you take your money, you have your fun, you don't have nothing when hollering come and I'm through cooking your stew and beans. And you can eat more naked bones than any man I've ever seen. Now if you want me, baby, you got to make your first showdown. If you want me, baby, make your first showdown.